guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Azine Williams. How are you all doing? Hope you guys are good. Hope you guys are fine. If you're new to this channel, kindly click on the subscription button. Click on the notification bell to let you know whenever I post any new video. Okay, guys, so while some of your faves are out here touching lives, bagging deals, the rest are busy on following each other and some other people are just chasing clout with it. Yes, guys. So in this video, I'm going to tell you who is chasing clout, who is unfollowing, and of course, who are making us proud by bagging deals and actually doing something nice for humanity. Yes, guys. Let's say a very big congratulations to JP. Like, JP has embarked on this project and I'm super proud of her because, I mean, she's following her profession as a nurse and she's also doing something that, you know, is well needed, especially in Nigeria and of course in the world at large. So JP is organizing this blood drive alongside Lekan and Pere. Like, this is really, really great. She put this out on her Twitter page and said, "My first project, someone told me everyone doesn't have to do the same thing. Find your niche and carve it. Thankful for the opportunity to be able to do things that really matter and cause impact. If you're in Lagos, please come. You get to meet me in person and we get to hang out." Like, this is genuinely, this is great. This is wonderful. Impacting people's life doesn't always have to be about giving them foodstuffs and all that. You can also do that in various ways. And we all know how blood transfusion is really important, especially for accident victims and people that need it. You know, we're in Nigeria where they will tell you, oh, there's no blood in a blood bank and all that. Now, this blood drive is actually very, very good. I admire and I applaud JP for this. Like, this is how you do something nice with your fame. You know, this is really, really good. And the people she brought on board, we have, you know, Pere, we have Lekan, and we all know that these two people are, you know, somehow affiliated with the medical field. We all know how smart and intelligent Lekan is. Pere was once a nurse, you know, and Lekan is very, 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 very passionate about, you know, people's health and all that. So this is really, really good. I applaud JP for this. Now, if you are in Lagos, you can actually come over to Mo Afrique, 4B Wole Afrio Street off Admiralty Way, Lakey Phase 1. And it's on the 17th of June from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. So for more inquiries, you can just check out the flyers and, you know, do what you can do or donate if you have anything to donate to them. This is really, really good. Well done, JP. Now, away from that, guess what? Tacha is now an OAP with Cool FM. Yes, guys. So she will be on our radios every Friday. I am super proud of this babe. Like, see, yeah. Me and Tacha, our love, hey, I stood up for this babe even when she was in Big Brother house. I chop insults. Ah, people insult me. Hey, they insult me on top of this babe. They say, Tacha can never get any deal. Just give it how many words. Nobody wants to work with Tacha. But look at her now. Look at her now. Like, look at her now. Since 2019, babe has always been relevant. Like, I'm proud. I won't even lie, this one past gist. This one will be gist. I'm actually very proud of her. I'm so proud of her achievements. I'm proud of her growth. Like, whenever I look at Tacha achieving great things, I'm like, yeah, I'm happy people are actually seeing what I saw, what a few of us saw back then and decided to support her. This is good. I remember the first interview that Tacha ever granted was with Cool FM. I remember how he broke the internet because everybody was like, when will Tacha talk? When will Tacha talk? And it was at Cool FM. You know, I think it was Dotun, D-O-T-U-N. You know, he was the one that interviewed her. I remember I joined. It was on radio. I remember a lot of Tacha's items were like, don't ask her stupid questions and all that. Look at her from being the one that was interviewed to being the one we are going to be hearing her voice on our radio stations. Like, well done, Tacha. I am proud of you. I'm sure your fans are proud of you. Yes, guys. Now, away from that, let's move over to the Unfollowing and Unfollowers Association of Big Brother. You know, every time we see an end of every Big Brother season, there's always a lot of drama that follows with the unfollowing and following and all that. Well, this time we had Yvonne unfollow Olivia, and this comes, you know, at the back of all the assumptions, you know, that people had that Olivia was making reference to Yvonne in that podcast. You know, a lot was said and all that. Well, Yvonne unfollowed Olivia, and after like 4 or 5 hours yesterday, Olivia returned the favor. Yes, guys, and it did not go without drama. Of course, we had Yvonne put out this on her Insta story and said, "Now happiness they reign now, now mumu they vest." And then we saw Olivia put this, you know, laughing emoji tries, you know, on her Insta story. Honestly, do I expect this kind of write-off from Yvonne? No. Honestly, it's like I've been scammed. I feel scammed, honestly. I honestly feel scammed because this isn't what I expected from her. Like, there are housemates that, you know, do something in the house, and then when I see stuff like that, I'm like, yeah, I mean, I'm not surprised, because this person actually showed me that this is how this person was in the house, so I'm not surprised. But this one, I won't lie, I'm actually shocked by all this. Now, I'm hearing that, you know, all these things is deeper than all this we are seeing on social media. I heard yesterday that Olivia borrowed somebody for Millionaire, and the person is owing her for AMVCAs. Like, why is it that people always owe people, you know, just to look good at the AMVCAs? Like, I don't understand. 4 million naira. It's a big money, oh, haba. Just to go and wear a dress and appear nice, you now go to owe somebody. Now, wow. Anyways, you know, as they are, you know, having their issues, some other people are cashing in on this, you know, to grow their clout. And I'm talking about Sandra. Now, this fight, I honestly don't think it has anything to do with Sandra. But ever since, you know, for the past how many days now, Sandra has been putting her mouth in things that does not concern her. Well, she put this out on her snap and said, "Friendship, Sha, is not by force, and from now on, energy will be reciprocated. You don't do. Before you all think I'm slow or something, I see you." After putting this out, somebody made a comment with which she put this picture on and said, "Yvonne, Sandra, and Jenny O, the realest, make this one work for me." So basically, from what I'm seeing, she's indirectly taking sides with Yvonne. Now, whatever it is, it's crazy that Sandra will be carrying it on her head, because isn't friendship all about people, you know, fight and reconcile? And if you are in the middle of two friends, isn't your job to kind of like find a middle ground for the both of them, rather than coming out on social media and chasing clout with it? You know, makes sense, Rara. Now it just makes me think that all this was just, you know, they were not really friends now, were they? Honestly, they were not really friends. Anyways, away from that, the Trend Up Awards has released their nomination list for different categories of awards for this year. Yes, guys, we have the Force of Instagram nominees, where we have a lot of, you know, influencers like Taoma, It's Prezi, that is Iyabojo's daughter, Bimbo Adamoye, one of my favorite Nigerian or Nollywood actresses, Tomike, I love her, and of course, Eniolua. I mean, who doesn't love any? And then we have our boy Shags. Yeah. In the Imagine Force nominee category, we have Salen Kingin, Jay One, I love him. Real Sophie, I love her. She's so beautiful, even though she tries so hard, you know, to tone down her beauty in her comedies. We had Layi Omo, I love Layi. We had Abike Sugar, and of course, our very own Yemi Craigs. In the Force of Lifestyle Content nominees, we have Diadem, Coco, we have Afri, okay, I can't really pronounce the name, we have This Other Person, we have our Neo and Beauty, wow. And in the Force of Online Sensation nominees, we have Yemoli. Yeah, this guy was in a very crazy scandal days ago, and we have the phenomenal Charles Okocha, we have Poco Lee, the ever, you know, dancing guy, we have Timmy, we have Tiana, had a king of fashion, and we have our very own Phina, Unusual Phina, the winner of Big Brother Naija Season 7. Now, in the Force of Creative Art category, we have Cotty, we have this guy, we have that guy, we have I Am Tom, I love his edits, we have this other guy, and then we have our very own Saga. Yes, I'm biased like that. I always talk about our people, so yeah. Anyways, these are the categories. How do you vote? All you have to do, I think, is to share on your Instagram stories and then comment the name of the person you want to win on that age post that concerns them. Yes, guys, I think it's with different accounts, so the person that has the highest mentions is the winner of that category. So good luck to them all, and to you, the fan bases, you all know what to do to come true for your faves. Yes, guys, on that note, I'd like to say a very big thank you to you all for being part of my channel. If you have not yet subscribed, what exactly are you waiting for? Kindly click on the subscription button, click on the notification bell to let you know whenever I post any new video. Until I come your way again, I remain your darling girl, Azine Williams. Have yourself a beautiful, wonderful day ahead.